Good morning, students. Welcome to the second session. Hope you all are fine and fit at home. Stay safe. I think all of you have seen the previous video lecture and noted all the important points in your rough copy. Keep learning it. Today also, when you watch the video, please make a note of all the important points in your rough copy. Okay, students? Now, let's have a revision of the first session. Last class, we had studied about data, information, data storage units, and computer memory. Now, what is data, children? Data is a collection of organized facts or details from which information is derived. Data can be in the form of alphabets, numbers, symbols, images, audio, and video. What is information? Processed data is called information or output. Information is a set of data that is processed in a meaningful way according to the given requirement. Data storage units are used to measure the stored data. Information is stored in the computer in the form of binary digits 0 and 1. A computer memory is the hardware of a computer that stores data and information. Now, today we will study about types of memory. What is memory? As the name indicates, memory means the place where we can store something. For example, a water tank is used to store water. Just like that, in a computer system, memory is very important to store data and instructions. So students, storage devices are used to store data and instructions. Memory is the basic unit of a computer where it can store data and instructions. It provides space for storing data and instructions and also the output. The memory capacity determines how much data can be stored in a computer, either temporarily or permanently. So, memory is the hardware of a computer. The memory of a computer can be divided into two types. Which are they? Primary memory and secondary memory. Now we will study about internal memory. Internal memory is also called primary memory or main memory. Why it is called the main memory? Because it is directly accessed by the processor. What is the processor? Do you know? The CPU is called the processor of a computer. The processor cannot store any data and program. So, primary memory is the built-in memory designed to store data and instructions while the computer is working. It can be directly accessed by the central processing unit. Or, it is the area where data is stored for quick access by the central processing unit. The computer processes and keeps data and files in the primary memory until the process is completed. It is used to hold the running programs and instructions. It is easier to access data or programs from the internal memory, as it is the fastest of all forms of computer data storage. Now, students, the internal memory is divided into two types: random access memory and read-only memory. Now, what is RAM? RAM stands for random access memory. Now we will study about random access memory. It stores the information temporarily. That means it is a short-term memory. It stores the information until the power is switched off. It works like a blackboard that can be constantly overwritten with new data. Once you rub the data from a blackboard, can you get it back from a blackboard? No. If I say another example, RAM is just like a calculator where information exists when the calculator is on. The moment you turn off the calculator, all the data disappears, isn't it? Yes. So student, same way, RAM is a volatile memory. Now, what is a volatile memory? Do you know? I will tell you. Volatile means it stores the data till the power is switched off. Once you turn off the computer, nothing can remain in random access memory. It becomes blank, like when a blackboard is rubbed. Nothing remains after that, isn't it? Well, RAM is fast and the expensive memory of a computer. It is the fastest memory and the same time it is expensive also. It is a read and write memory of a computer. What is read and write memory? That means the processor can read the instruction from RAM, random access memory, and write the result to the random access memory. The processor can read the instruction from RAM and also write the result to RAM back. Okay. Now, RAM chip is a very small metal oxide semiconductor chip used for storing programs during the execution of programs. Where is this RAM located? Or where is it placed? Do you know? It is located on the motherboard. It is placed in the slot on the motherboard. You can see the picture on the screen. This is a RAM. Okay. The motherboard is also called a system board. So the RAM chip is placed on the slot of the motherboard. It is a physical hardware inside a computer. It stores programs temporarily. Okay, and serves as the working memory of a computer. So RAM is the working memory of a computer. It stores data and instructions used by the CPU currently to perform a current task or during the execution of a program, which stores program and data that is required by the CPU. These instructions are usually loaded into RAM from the secondary memory or a secondary storage device like a hard disk. First, the instructions are loaded into the random access memory from the secondary memory. Maybe it may be a pen drive, from a pen drive, or maybe from a hard disk. Okay. Every time a file is opened, it is placed into the random access memory. Suppose if you are using an MS Word file, the work is used in RAM on temporary basis. You opened a file and you are typing something in. Your work is in RAM. It is saved in RAM, random access memory, on a temporary basis. When the computer is turned off, it will be lost. So, it is a short-term memory. It is a temporary memory. The contents can be remain in RAM till the computer is switched off. The data stored in RAM is erased when the computer is turned off. It requires power to keep data. So, random access memory needs power to keep the data. So, what you have to do is, before switching off a computer, you have to save the file, save the data to a permanent storage device like a hard disk. Okay? Now, the CPU gets the data, it reads from random access memory, process it, and write the new data back to the random access memory in a continuous cycle. CPU gets the data from RAM, process it. After processing, the data is saved back to the external memory, secondary memory device like a hard disk. Okay? So, this is the continuous cycle followed. Okay? It is the smallest storage area in your computer where the application programs and data in current use are kept. It allows the CPU to access data randomly and quickly. It is made up of metal oxide semiconductor. Okay? Now we will study about the types of random access memory. There are two types of random access memory. They are static RAM and dynamic RAM. What is static RAM? It stores a bit of data using a state of a 6 transistor memory cell. In dynamic RAM, data is stored with the help of capacitors and transistors. It is less expensive when compared to the static RAM. Now, we will move to the next topic, that is read-only memory, ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. It is also located on the motherboard of a computer. It is a permanent memory. ROM is a permanent memory. It holds the startup instructions or bootstrap instructions that prepare a computer for use. Now, what is bootstrap instructions? Bootstrap is the process of booting up of a computer, or it is the initial starts up operations that a computer performs when you switch on a computer. When the computer is switched on, the instructions in ROM, read-only memory, are automatically activated. These instructions help the booting process of a computer. Alright? Now, the instructions in ROM are burnt into the memory chips by using a laser technology by the manufacturer. It cannot be changed or modified by the user. It retains the stored information even when the computer power is off. That is why it is called non-volatile memory. So, ROM, read-only memory, is a non-volatile memory. As the name indicates, the data stored in ROM can only be read. can only be read. It cannot be changed. We cannot add or delete the contents of read-only memory. In DROM, data remains same always. Now we will study about different types of read-only memory. The first one is programmable read-only memory, in short PROM. In this type of read-only memory, the contents of the memory can be written only once. If there is any error in writing, the instructions or data in DROM, the error cannot be changed. PROM chips become unusable. That means the instructions can be written only once by the manufacturer. Okay. Now, the second type is erasable programmable read-only memory, that is EPROM. Okay. This is a programmable read-only memory. Data can be erased by using ultraviolet rays. What is it? Ultraviolet rays, and then data can be rewritten onto it. Written instructions can be erased with the help of ultraviolet rays and rewrite the information. Alright? Okay. Now the third type is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory, EPROM. Okay. Now let's see what is this EPROM. It allows the user to change the contents of ROM with the help of electrical devices and reprogrammed many times. So using the electrical devices, you can reprogram this device many times. You require specialized software and hardware to change the contents of read-only memory. Alright. Now let's see the differences between random access memory and read-only memory. Random access memory stores the data temporarily. That means it is a temporary memory. It is a short-term memory. Until the power goes, it stores data. But read-only memory stores the data permanently. Data remains same always, whether power supply is there or not. Okay. Now the second point is RAM, random access memory, is known as volatile memory. I told you already what is volatile memory. That means the data stored in RAM is lost when the power supply is turned on. But ROM, read-only memory, is a non-volatile memory. That means the information remains even if the power supply is turned off. Okay. Now, RAM, random access memory, is a read-write memory. It is used by the CPU either to read data from it or to write data onto it. Whereas read-only memory is used by the CPU only to read the data. We cannot make any changes in that. Okay. Only we can read the data. We cannot write anything. Next point is, it stores the data that has to be currently processed by the CPU. RAM stores the data that is currently used by the CPU. Whereas read-only memory stores the instructions required during the bootstraps of a computer, startup instructions. Okay. Data in RAM can be modified. You can read or write the data from RAM. But read-only memory data cannot be modified. RAM is a costlier memory. It is a faster memory and costlier also. Comparatively, ROM is cheaper than RAM. So these are some of the differences between random access memory and read-only memory. Now, we will move to the next topic, catch memory. What is a catch memory? Have you heard of? This is a third type of memory known as catch memory. Catch is a very fast memory. That is placed in between the CPU and random access memory. You can see on the screen where catch is placed. Okay, in between the CPU and random access memory. It is closer to the CPU than RAM. It holds frequently used data and instruction so that they are immediately available to the CPU when needed. Catch memory can be accessed faster than random access memory. Catch memory is used to reduce the average memory access time. Now, we will just revise what we have learned today. First, we learn about internal memory. What is internal memory? Internal memory is also called as primary memory or main memory. It stores programs and instruction that can be directly accessed by the central processing unit. Internal memory is of two types, random access memory and read-only memory. Then we studied about random access memory. Random access memory stores the information temporarily. It is a type of memory where the programs and data currently in use are kept. It is of two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. Then we studied about read-only memory. Read-only memory contains programs and instructions that a computer needs to operate. It is a permanent memory. Some types of read-only memory are programmable read-only memory, erasable programmable read-only memory, and electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Then we studied about catch memory. What is catch memory? Catch is a very fast memory that is placed in between the CPU and the main memory. It is a temporary memory used to store data that is likely to use again. Today, I will give you some homework also. This is your homework. Write the full forms of the following. You have to write the full forms of this RAM, ROM, EPROM, PROM, WPROM. Okay. Meet you in the next session. Thank you.